The second myth concerns going across protection domains, and especially if the protection domains are implemented as distinct hardware address spaces, then the myth is that crossing protection domains implemented using hardware address space switch is expensive. And we are now talking explicit cost for crossing protection domains implemented as distinct hardware address spaces, not the implicit cost. We're only talking about the explicit cost of crossing protection domain. Now, let's understand what is involved in an address space switch. This is a refresher to show you what exactly is happening in terms of translating a virtual address to a physical address. You all know about the concept of a TLB. And the virtual address consists of two parts, an index part and a tag. The index is used to look up the TLB, and the tag that is contained in that particular entry of the TLB is matched against the tag coming from the virtual address. If they match, then we got a hit. Then this particular virtual address is contained in the TLB entry, and you've got the physical frame number that corresponds to the virtual page number that you started with. So that is your very simple TLB matching hardware that does the address translation from virtual page number to physical page number. Now, what happens on an address space switch, that is a context switch going from one address space to another address space? On a context switch, the virtual address to physical address mapping will change for the new process that is going to be scheduled. So in other words, if the TLB contains the translations for a particular process that is currently executing on the CPU, if we do a context switch, do we have to flush the TLB because the virtual address to physical address mapping is going to be different for the new process or new thread that is going to run on the processor now? The answer to the question, do we have to throw away the mappings that exist in the TLB when we do a context switch, is depends. It depends on whether the TLB has a way of recognizing that the virtual to physical address translation that is contained in it is flagged by the distinct process for which those translations have been put into the TLB. Or in other words, if the TLB has address space tags in addition to the tag for disambiguating one virtual address from another virtual address, then you don't have to flush the TLB. So these are what are called address space tag TLBs, which contain the process ID for which a particular TLB entry is present in the TLB. MIPS architecture, for instance, uses address space tagged TLBs. But on the other hand, an architecture may not use an address space tagged TLB. Intel 486 and Intel Pentium are examples of architectures that do not have address space tags associated in the TLB. So in an Intel architecture, at the point of the context switch, you have to throw away all the entries that are there in the TLB on behalf of the process. In the Intel architecture, actually, the TLB is split into two parts, a user part and a kernel part. And the kernel part is common regardless of which process is running. And therefore, you don't have to flush that portion of the TLB, the kernel portion of the TLB. But the user portion of the TLB has to be flushed on a context switch because the virtual address to physical address mapping is going to be different for the new process that starts to run on the processor.